I want to say a big thank you to all of the Patreon supporters, and also a big thank you to those of you who are a member on this channel. More information in the description box. Okay, so it may look like I'm wearing the same t-shirt that I was yesterday. I assure you, it's just coincidence. This just happens to be a white t-shirt, or am I filming two videos in one day? We'll never know. I'm not. Today we're going to talk about the term mastering lucid dreaming. It's a term that I despise, it's a term that I hate, and it's a term that always makes me on edge every time I hear it. It's either from a video, or it's from a blog post, or it's from a tweet or a Facebook post, something similar. And every time I hear the phrase mastering lucid dreaming, it sets me on edge, like I just mentioned. But it's the same kind of way when you hear, when you're walking down the street and then you hear somebody say the word boobs, and then you go, oh, hang on, what? Something's going on here. And then you kind of try and just tune in your hearing into the conversation that they're having. And when I see the word mastering lucid dreaming, I think of the same thing, because every time I hear it or I read it, then I focus in so much on what they're saying, because I have to be really critical of what they're saying, because there is no such thing as mastering lucid dreaming. Okay, allow me to explain. So lucid dreaming is a skill. It's a skill that you build over time. And Daniel Love, aka the Lucid Guide, had a really good simile when it came to using, or an analogy, when it came to using the term, learn how to lucid dream in an hour. If you use that kind of phrasing, it's very troubling to me. With Daniel Love's example, he says, if you replace the word lucid dreaming with learning French, as it's both a skill, and you hear someone say, I'll teach you how to learn French in an hour, it makes you go, well, no, you can teach me the basics, you can teach me some words, you can teach me maybe some sentence structures or some pronouns, but you can't teach me how to learn French in an hour. It's just not possible. With the word mastering lucid dreaming, it's exactly the same. If you hear somebody, or if you read somewhere that says, I will teach you how to master lucid dreaming, that has to send you on edge. Because again, if we take this analogy of the subway, I've got a coupon for Subway. If we take the analogy of learning French and apply it to this, then I will teach you how to master French. You can't master French. What? How do you master something? When you know everything about it, or when you have learned everything about it, or when you can apply what you've learned to what you know? Or how about you apply your skill in it? Can you do everything all the time? That's when it gets me on edge. So when I hear the term mastering lucid dreaming, I have to be super critical, because I'm very cautious about everything that they say after that. So I would be very cautious yourself about, when you hear the term mastering lucid dreaming, think about what they're saying. Really think about what they say. I don't want to give examples of people who have done this, because with the whole Koi Fresco fiasco of last year, I made a video on why Koi Fresco is wrong, and he was wrong, and he still is wrong. But people just freaked out about me criticizing somebody else for something that they've done, which is wrong. And they completely freaked out. It was a bit of a nightmare. So I'm not going to give any examples. Can't be bothered with the backlash that I received. Be very careful with the verbiage. Be very careful with the wording of what you say, because what you say lasts forever. And if you say that lucid dreaming is a skill that you can master, then be very cautious, because it's not a skill that you can master. And the reason it's not a skill that you can master is because we don't know everything about lucid dreaming. We don't know everything about how dreams operate. We don't even know why we dream, and yet we claim that we can master lucid dreaming. So thank you very much for everyone who has supported the channel. If you are a Patreon supporter like these people and members of the YouTube channel, then please accept my greatest thanks. Tomorrow's video is called Just Do It, or something on the lines of that. And I will see you tomorrow for that video. And until next time, bye.